Hello and welcome to episode 12 of Let's Play Civilization 6. My war with the Congo continues, and I'm still having a bit of an issue with warnings because units will be close to my city and I'll be in range to attack and I wouldn't see it. So I think this boat might be on the way here, so we'll keep an eye out on that. In Civ 5, actually, if an enemy is in bombard range, you'll get news alerts. Maybe it's a setting that's turned off, but I don't see it in the options. I'll check again later. Let's see if there's any quests I can trigger. Inspiration for Cold War, professional sports. Okay. One interesting thing is, I think they made the right decision here. So there's a source of aluminum under my military base, and another source here that's unmined. So rather than punishing people, because aluminum is a resource that pops later on in the game, and you might place an encampment or a district in the early game, not knowing something else is gonna pop there. So the system they've done is, they're just gonna give that to you, access to that resource. You don't necessarily have to mine it, because I can see here I have aluminum now, and it's the one sitting right under here, even though that's not a mine. It's just, it's a good system. I mean, I think that that's a right decision to make, to not to punish people for not seeing ahead of time that, there's this resource that's gonna be there later on in the game. What else do I need to be doing here? There's gonna be probably some more units coming out here. I'm gonna rest this. I guess he can't move now. He's done his turn. Yeah, these are done their turns. Which units? Oh, this unit needs orders, but I'm gonna fortify him. And I'm gonna move this guy back, actually. Nope, he's done his turn as well. So we're on to the next turn. Another thing in Civ 5, Brave New World, is if you hover over a trade unit, you'll see where they're going to. And here, I can't see where they're going to. There's their boat. I can see my trade routes, I guess. To Valletta, to Seoul. I guess I'll build a neighborhood. Okay, so our agents have acquired enough knowledge that now we have ranked up. So I'm gonna go to the spy menu. Go to my spy here. And I can now conduct all these espionage missions. Yeah, let's go for this. Siphon some gold from them. 74 chance of success, 21% chance of mission failure, 5% chance of being captured or killed. And then if it's captured, this will give Congo a casus belli to declare war on us. But they already are at war with us, so we don't really care. Our only concern is actually the spy getting killed. Failure is okay as long as they're still alive, because they live to fight another day. And it's gonna take 8 turns to complete, and I'm gonna get this much gold from them. Okay, accept that mission. Rest that unit. I'm still not quite sure what all the upgrade trees for the cavalry units are. It's a little bit confusing, because I thought I was gonna get upgrade my horses straight to Rough Riders. But I can't. I actually have to build a Rough Rider separately. You can see here, this cavalry I upgraded from my horseman, and this knight I've had forever. But I don't know where, how to, what path Rough Riders are. Maybe they don't belong to any upgrade path, and I just have to build them when I get them. And that's maybe a way of the game controlling exploits. So I don't know. The only downside here is I can't move my artillery and fire in the same turn. Even though it's saying I can, this is targetable. If I move it, this option goes away. So, let me move this down here. So I have to watch this. This is a core, knight core, so it's a little bit stronger than the usual units. Where is that frigate that they had? Down there. Okay. I have a builder here. Let's see here. Yeah. They just pillaged my harbor, which sucks. And I lose a trade route because of that, because harbors give me one trade route. The harbor. 24 turns. Ugh. Let's buy a builder and switch the harbor again. Well, this is why you kind of need to have a fleet to protect it, but one thing I'm kind of still struggling with is just how long it takes to build everything. Obviously, this is my first game, and I'm not very, I don't really know all the ins and outs of min-maxing certain things, but one thing I've found out reading the forums is the factories give production bonuses to within 6 tile radiuses of the factory itself. So there's one here, so it'll give production to all the cities within 6 tiles around it. So if you have bunch of cities like here, you probably want all your factories in one cluster so that all 6 cities or all the cities in that area get the bonus. And I can see here a factory gives me +3 production. I can see here if I click over here that I have +9 from factories. So this city, Washington, is getting the factory bonus from its own city, the one I have here. It's getting the bonus from this one, and it's getting the bonus probably from here. But St. Louis is actually getting plus 12 from factory. So he's getting from here, from this one, and I think from this one at New Orleans. Yeah, so Los Angeles is only getting plus 6 because I think it's only getting these two factories bonuses. So that's a layer of strategy that I haven't really thought about. And St. Louis's production is actually quite good at 47. This is 66, but you know, I have Wonders here that's buffing it up too. So this is probably my second most productive city is St. Louis. What's Charleston? 30, yeah. So what's how many factories? Only plus 6 from factory from Charleston. So, yeah, I think it's only getting from here and then from here, probably. It's not getting the one from St. Louis. Maybe too far away, yeah. Yeah, so that's the other thing. And here, there's no factory bonuses, and it's going to take me 24 turns to do that, which sucks. Let's pillage a trade route. Okay. Trading with China.
The cars haven't advanced that much since we were kids. When you boil it down, it's still a gas combustion engine.
I like this modern atomic era version of of this American theme here. Oh, I can't attack it. Maybe it's line of sight issues. Where do we want to go? So we're way ahead of everyone in tech. So I think the Greeks beeline to democracy, but we actually have more techs overall than all of them combined. Got a great person, atomic era, great general. Do I want him? Well, it's a generic bonus. Zhukov. You know, wish for a crew this great person, and you'd rather save your great person points for a future approach. You can choose to pass. Pass costs 192 great person points. Cannot be undone. The points spent will apply to it as a discount on the next to the great person, allowing other players to acquire it for less points. Oh, I'm as well recruited. It's just a great general. Yeah, some of the great engineers, I instinctively want to pick one up every time I get it, but some of them don't give quite the right buffs. I think there's one that increases appeal to all my tiles. I thought I could rush build it with stuff, but actually I could not. Build another I need an aerodrome. Let's build a spy. I didn't. I wasn't gonna attack them. The promises thing I don't quite get yet. I know it's similar to Civ 5, but it seems a little bit more onerous. Core here. St. Louis. See what we can do with Brazil. They don't have much to give us. Make demand. What can we demand from them? Not much. It's gonna cost us Belay. Well, I can do the declare war of territorial expansion, which is less severe than the formal declaration of war. So as you advance through the civics tree, you unlock more and more things that you could do. Like you could declare wars of colonization earlier in the game, and it have different impact on your warmonger penalties and stuff. Okay, I have to move this guy here. I don't agree with this. I know our units are close to him, but we're fighting the Congolese. We're not actually doing anything. But I know I'm now... Discuss... Oh, I guess they were spying on us earlier. Make deal. Never mind. Casus Belli. Cancel. You can see here we have more wonders than him, so he's now not happy with us. That's one of his agendas. Okay, well. Let's rest him up. Send one to Agra. How much housing do we need for Rio? They're just not happy. We're about to finish the quests for Zanzibar, capitalism, train a biplane. Okay, we're another suzerain. I've been competing with China for that city-state since forever. It's a pain in the ass. See if Congo wants to just end this war. It's a little bit annoying now. Still don't want to end a war. Okay. They have oil, which we do not have. Oh, that's weird. We lost our supply of aluminum. I thought we had that. Maybe it doesn't give it to you if you have a district on top of it. I mean, perhaps I was looking at the coal, which is saying one coal. Yeah. Oh, no, I'm right. That's one aluminum. The zero here is for the envoys that I have to send. The UI, I have some issues with the UI, as I've been talking about. I'm sure they'll fix it, but there are things that could be improved. Let's keep it Washington. Confirm placement. We'll do counter spy. Los Angeles needs food, okay. Oh, I can build a seaside resort. What does that do? I guess it's for tourism outputs and stuff. I'll leave it for now. Tile is being worked on. Let's see if I can buy this tile here. Okay. Now I'm gonna go improve that one. They're just sending their knights for slaughter. I don't know why, but hey. Let's keep that trade route going. Ah, we lost Suzerain. Damn it. And we lost Suzerain on Preslav, too. Why? I have more influence. Oh no, we still have Suzerain for Preslav, but how about Nanamadol? The Chinese Titus. There's not a lot of things that give me food in this game. That's the other thing too. What do I want to build? Let's just build another warship. At least I finally have my battleship. Let's see here. Do I have access to... I do have access to food here. This food tile here. Yeah, let me get the builder out as well. Improve some of the lands. Let's see here, military strength. 1026, 942. 80 for Brazil. Okay, well, they've lost a lot of their military strength, although, again, I mentioned this earlier in an earlier episode. I think the game is just counting the number of units and multiplying it by some factor. It's not... I don't really think it's looking at the core system, because when I started combining my units, I actually lost military power. That might be a bug, or it might be by design, but it's not truly representative. I think if you have a high score, it's a good sign that the civ has a lot of units, but it doesn't speak to the quality of those units. I guess it's a good way of saying that. Oh, okay. Our spy was detected. Choose escape route. Interesting. Okay, our spy escaped. Whew. And you know, in terms of production, I can see why they intentionally set it so low, because if you set it too high, then you really have nowhere else to go on your expansions. You'll just, you know, expansions will necessarily add more buildings, more mechanics and such. And if you set it way too high, then all you're doing is you're making things inflate way too much in terms of expansion content. And I can see where they'll add buildings and maybe policies that do that later on in the game, in future expansions. Okay. Okay. Camp. Let's go back to LA here. Can we unclick? Swap. There we go.
it weren't for electricity, we'd all be watching television by candlelight.
Let's go with computers. Can I change switch government to it? Almost there. Oh, Seaport will give me food. Let's spend some money there. It's worth it. What else does Seaport give us? Two food, two gold. Let's do that here too. Oh, I can't build a lighthouse. Okay, I see. I gotta build a harbor first. And the other thing I mentioned was clustering farms is really productive in the late game. A lot of whales here, and fish. I guess not whales. Let's see. Some of these could be in range for my. Oh, this definitely is in range. So let's. No, I'm gonna hold because I'm gonna make a big purchase later on. So I don't wanna spend all my money. The religion side of the game I completely haven't really thought about yet, so I'll think about that later. Okay, that's counter spy. We're gonna send him back into Maza Congo. Let's see our internal trade routes. How is it going? New York to Seoul. Okay. I think we'll send that to New York. No, wait, we already have one to New York. St. Louis. Oh, okay. I've been doing this wrong because I've been sending trade routes from Washington to the cities I'm going to, but it's not giving me the buff because the food and the production goes to Washington, not to the destination city. I'm reading this wrong. I'm used to the Civ 5 model where the receiving city gets something from the trade route. So I've got two. Okay, I think I know what I want to do. I'm going to move this to New Orleans and then send a trade route to Rio. No, to Rio and then send a trade route to New Orleans, or yeah, to New Orleans, so I can create a road between these two cities. Let's do that, just as an internal thing. Let's see here. Where's my. Where's that unit? There we go. Travel to New City. No, we don't want to travel to New City. I don't want to. No, that's a spy. There we go. Transfer to another city, and we want to give it to Leo. I wonder what this does. Let's try that. 5 gold. Okay, that's her. Oh, this is a good one. Greece, India. Okay. Even if I don't get suzerain, I can still get up to plus 4 gold in every commercial. Plus 4 and then another 4, so that's 8. Plus the actual 4 I'm getting from a capital right now, which is not a bad suzerain. Okay, and that's because I finished the aerodrome, I believe. Yes, I can start building my planes now. Maybe. I'll have to build a hangar first. Or my planes, can I build planes? Yes, I can. That's the American Unique Unit P-51 Mustang. But let's build a hangar first. Give me 2 production. Okay, let's move them back here. This is gonna grow soon, so I'm gonna improve a tile before it grows. Again, that's really weird. Like, I only see it now. Move this up here. Okay. That's Rio. That's gonna go to New Orleans, right? Yeah, so Rio is going to get all this extra stuff, which we want. Okay. Okay, I think I'll play one more turn and then we'll end this episode. We're running a bit long today. Disorders. Let's make a resort here. What do I get from this? Okay, I get gold. I see. So you get gold. It just makes your civ produce way more gold. So we're on to our next turn. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time.